In this video, we'll look at a chemical reaction and talk about the relationship between the amounts of reactants and the amount of products. Consider the combustion of butane, C4H10. 2 C4H10 plus 13 O2 yields 8 CO2 plus 10 H2O. In a particular reaction, 456 grams of butane is combusted. How much water is formed? So first of all, on the left-hand side of the equation are the reactants, and on the right-hand side are the products. Here's our butane right here, and oxygen, and then carbon dioxide, and H2O is the water. So what's going on? Well, we're burning the butane. By the way, butane is something you find in a lighter or in a tiny pen torch. So burning 456 grams of it would be quite a lot, or a lot of lighters, maybe at a concert or something. So this is what's happening. This butane is being burned, combusted, or reacting with the oxygen in the air, and it's yielding carbon dioxide and water. So how does this work? Well, the 456 grams can be converted into a number of moles, and that's what we're going to do. We're going to first convert this amount into a number of moles, and we'll find how many moles of butane are being combusted. So let's first do that. And the 456 grams of butane of the C4H10. And the way we convert this, we will multiply by the correct conversion. And I know that 1 mole of butane equals 58.12 grams. Now that is the molecular mass of butane, of C4H10. And let me just talk about how I got that. That is found by the C4H10 molecular formula, and I'm multiplying 4 moles of carbon. And that's so 4 times the molar mass of carbon, which is 12.01, plus 10 times the molar mass of hydrogen, which is 1.008. And that's how I get to this 58.12 grams of this per mole. Okay, so we do this conversion, and we get approximately 7.84584 moles of this butane, C4H10. Now, notice that I have not worried about significant figures here. And it's a good idea to hang on to all of your digits until you get to the end. So don't round too early. You only worry about the significant digits on your final answer, because you don't want to make a rounding error. It would compound if you kept rounding too early. So we hang on to all that stuff. Now, what do we do with this? Well, if we have this many moles of the butane, let's look at this. For every 2 moles of butane that are burned, it yields, this chemical reaction yields 10 moles of water. So we get 5 times as much. We don't know the mass because we haven't figured out the mass of the water yet, but we do know that we get 5 times the moles of water. Right? See how that works? For every 2 of butane, we get 10 of water. So a lot of oxygen is coming into play there, of course, because you can't get more than what you begin with, but remember that we're adding the oxygen as well to the butane, so that's why we get so much more water. Okay, so what are we going to do here? Well, we're going to multiply. If we had 7.84584 moles of butane, we'll say 7.84584 multiplied by 5, because of this, we get 5 times the amount of water as we started with on butane. And now that is approximately equal to 39.229 moles of H2O. Okay, so if the question had asked for the number of moles of H2O of water, then we'd have an answer here. We'd round to three significant digits, because that's what we have here is three significant digits. But how much water? We don't speak in terms of moles. We speak in terms of some mass or some volume. So let's do that. Let's talk about, let's convert the number of moles into the number of grams of water. So we've got 39.229 moles of H2O of the water. And converting this, now I'm going to put mole in the denominator when I'm converting units, because I want to get rid of these moles. And for every 1 mole of water, I know the molecular mass of water is 18.016 grams. And the way I know that is just the way I did it with the butane up here. I've got two hydrogen masses plus 1 molar mass of oxygen. And the molar mass of oxygen is 16.00. So that's 2 times 1.008 plus 1 times 16.00. And that's how I get this 18.016. Okie dokie. What does that give us? That gives us, let's block that off, that gives us approximately 706.753 grams of H2O of water. Or, staying with our three significant digits, that would be 707 grams of water. And because of the density of water, 1 gram of water is 1 milliliter of water. You can talk about this in terms of volume as well. 707 milliliters of water. Quite a bit. But quite a bit of butane was burned. And by the way, again, remember, this is we're not creating something out of nothing. We had 456 grams of butane, but we added a lot of oxygen in there. And just 1 mole of oxygen is 16.00, but this is O2, so it would be 32 grams for just 1 mole of oxygen, times 13 of those to react with every 2 moles of the C4H10. So anyway, we're adding a lot to that, and this equation is balanced, and so we get a lot of water, 707 milliliters of water. I hope that was helpful. If you found this video helpful, consider liking it or sharing it with a friend.